Okay, hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Half-Life. And this time we're playing the DLC, Blue Shift. And in this one we will be playing as Barney something, McGowan, I think. We'll basically be playing as the police officers, the officers of this game. If you remember in the other episodes. So I'm gonna go and click new game, but first I have to turn down the volume on my get on the recording for you guys because this is fucking retarded actually. Literally just loaded up the game for the first time, so I have absolutely nothing. I should probably have set up the keys, but whatever. No, wait. I'm so dumb. Let's see, where's AI is set by default. No, that's not what I meant at all. Come on. Mouse filter. Yeah, I think we need 10.0. Directly access mouse data. What the hell does that mean? No, thank you. We'll trigger that off for now. We might need it later on, but you know. The hell is this? Wonder what this is. I wonder what it would look like. Does it just sense everything? Because that's pretty neat. I don't know what happened there. Okay, we're back. I had to whenever it resets a thing or whatever, it tends to it tells me that the game restarts, but apparently that's not what happened. So I feel all good with that. Let's go on hard. No, just kidding. Let's go on training room. You're not funny, Levi. Shouldn't be slower. Hazard course. Did I load the wrong game by accident? Nope.
Welcome to the Black Mesa Hazard Course for Security Guard Training. I'll be your holographic guide to assist you in your training. Begin by putting on your vest and helmet. You'll find this equipment in the next room. Whenever you see one of these buttons, press it and I'll repeat instructions or show you how things are done.
No, you won't. You never did that before. Can I go through you? Yes, I can.
Here you will find your standard armor vest and helmet. These will help protect you against any physical threat you may encounter while performing your duties. When your armor becomes too damaged to be useful, you'll need to find a fresh vest or helmet to protect yourself.
Okay. So you don't recharge these like in the other games. That makes sense.
Moving around in your armor may be a little tricky at first. Take a moment to get a feel for moving around. Once you get comfortable with this, proceed to the next section just around the corner.
Okay, sir. Am I young or am I old like that guy? Yeah, I remember this from the last episode. Still can't open that door. God knows. God only knows what's behind there.
The first move you'll need to practice is jumping. You'll have to get over all three of these obstacles in order to proceed. It helps to get a running start. Watch me do it, then try it yourself.
Okay.
You'll need to duck under the next set of obstacles. When you crawl in a crouched position, you can move very silently. This can be very useful when you don't want to be heard.
All right. Yeah, I know how this is done.
Very good. I hardly Thanks. Noticed you. Come on to the next area.
Thank you.
Now, try combining moves. You'll need to jump, duck, and then jump again. This should get you prepared for the next room, where you'll have to do both moves at the same time.
Good work. You look prepared for the next stage.
Okay, thanks, buddy. I honestly thought that I had loaded up the wrong game at first, but no, this is completely different.
To get into these pipes, you'll need to perform a duck jump. You'll want to stand right at the mouth of the pipe. While moving forward, jump up and hold the jump button to go into a crouch in midair. It may be tricky at first, but you'll find it comes in handy to be able to jump and duck into tight areas.
Okay, thanks. I know how to do this. This is basically the same as before, isn't it? But with minor changes. I should have kind of expected... No, that's not what I was expecting. I was expecting paperwork or something.
Nice work.
Thanks, buddy. Uh-oh. God, no. I hate that buzzing sound.
Walk directly into the ladder, look up, and continue moving forward. If you want to climb back down, just move backward.
Okay, can I actually repeat, or are you just going to be lying to me?
Walk directly into the ladder, look up, and continue moving forward. If you want to climb back down, just move backwards.
Why did that never work in the, Excuse me? Why did that never work in the first one?
The next four jumps get more difficult each time. Don't worry if you miss the last one a few times, just climb up and do it again. If you can make all the jumps in a continuous run, you're doing just fine.
Okay, thanks.
If you keep falling short, you may be jumping too soon.
Yeah, probably. I got a little overexcited there. The last DLC as I'm concerned. And space is used to jump off of it.
To start the lift, walk up to the button and press the use key while facing it.
Okay.
Now that you're up here, there's only one way down. Find the target on the floor below and do your best to hit it. You may take some damage from the fall, but don't worry about it. We'll give you some first aid in the next section.
I can never get on that thing properly. I mean, the FPS is way better than I remember.
You'll find medical kits like this one throughout the Black Mesa Research Facility. To restore your health, walk up to a med kit, then press and hold your use key. Your health will recover gradually until you're at full health or until the kit is depleted. Once the light goes out, a med kit cannot be reused.
Okay.
You may also find HEV charging stations, such as this one, throughout the facility. These stations, however, can only be used by qualified science personnel wearing powered hazardous environment equipment, so they will be inaccessible to you during your duties.
Okay, that's useful. I wonder how many people saw this at first and decided, you know what, I'm going to skip this. I already know all this shit. But you don't know it actually. I will not be surprised if the majority of people who played this and thought, I already know this, knows that. I would not be surprised if there's a lot of them. There didn't appear to be a training room in the second one.
To spin that bridge, walk up to the control wheel and press the use key.
That has a different texture than I remember.
Great job.
Ten minutes already? Jesus Christ.
Sometimes you'll need to rely on quick reflexes to get around. Try jumping this gap on your own. What you really need to do is push the box down into the pit. Pushing is easy. Just move forward into the box, and you can push it into position.
Okay, thanks. I cheated in the last one. This time, I'm actually going to take it seriously. And I hope I'm not being drained out by the face.
If you can't push an obstacle out of the way, you might try pulling it. To pull a box, move up to it and press your use key. While holding down the use key, move backwards, and the box will be pulled with you.
Okay. Is the grabbing mechanic still awful? Practically, yeah.
Breaking things that block your path. Pick up the crowbar and smash your way through the boxes.
Alright, I got the shitty original crowbar that I didn't get in the Half-Life one thing I bought. I don't know why that was. I mean, I kind of wish I didn't do that. Yes, I remember this is Half-Life Source. I am positive we didn't get this in the original one.
You'll need to use your flashlight for the next area.
Okay, another flashlight here. Here. Oh, I did not expect that to work. I don't know why I thought that. That's breakable. Do I need my flashlight?
Great. Remember, your flashlight will lose power over time, so switch it off when you don't need it. When the flashlight is off, it will recharge itself.
No, it doesn't use power. I've never seen it use power, unless I'm a blind idiot.
Welcome to the Black Mesa Training Target Range. You'll get a chance to fire your weapon, reload, and fire the attached grenade launcher. Collect your equipment and proceed to the firing station.
Okay. I'm glad they kept the original shotgun, though. Yeah.
You'll need to hit every target to complete the course. If you miss, don't worry about it. The targets will keep moving until you manage to score a hit. If you want to get through the target range as quickly as possible, try reloading during pauses instead of letting your gun run out of ammunition at a critical time. To fire the grenade launcher, use the alternate fire button. Some targets can only be destroyed by lobbing grenades. I'll start the sequence in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Advance to the next area.
Okay, thanks. Did the hologram lady say that in the original one? I'm pretty sure she did, but I don't remember.
Your heads-up display will let you know when oxygen becomes critical. That means you'll need to find some clean air to breathe. As you swim through this course, your blood oxygen levels will begin to drop. At the midpoint, you'll be given an opportunity to surface for air.
Air.
To the surface to catch your breath. You regain health lost from holding your breath too long once you've made it to the surface for air. Go ahead and swim on to the next section.
Sweat. Where's that coming from anyway?
If you pass through fire or steam, you'll see damage icons come up in your heads-up display. Directional indicators at the center of your display will show you from what direction damage is coming.
Okay. Okay, thanks for that. I remember that. Didn't scare the crap out of me this time. Radiation has exactly. But cool, a friend is playing Garry's Mod. Hey Brody, you're on YouTube now. I think, so I think. Cool. Why is this not working?
Proximity to radiation activates a Geiger counter and radiation display in your helmet. Many other biological and chemical hazards are also indicated in your hands-on display. Please proceed to the next section.
I like this. I know what I'm doing now. I felt smart doing it. Entering civilian era. Removing weapons now. Okay.
Lead a scientist into the next room. He will open the door that leads back into the transit system. To have someone follow you, approach the person and press your use key. He will then follow you until you face him and press the use key again.
Yes, I will follow you if you wish.
Can I actually get a thing out here? Doesn't let me. Oh, it actually helps. I didn't realize. I was like, hey, is my health going up? Or am I just dreaming? Because I am fat now. I'm becoming like one of those fat guys. Fat guy bunnies. Excuse me, but I'm trying to get through.
Access denied.
I should be allowed through those, actually.
Access granted.
Oh, those are pretty. Are the graphics always that good? I mean, it's on the same engine, so it can't be any different.
Press your use key to engage the train. Once engaged, move forward or backward to increase or decrease the speed of the train. Press the use key a second time to disengage from the train.
Disconnect door, okay. I know. Shut up.
Congratulations on completing the Black Mesa Hazard Course for security guards. You're now certified to join the Blue Shift High Security Unit.
This is also the first, okay, there we go, that was the training room. There's also the first Half-Life game that has come out in this century. Now I'm just going to go and shut my closet because it's open and it's in the darkness. And I don't like it. It's in the darkness. Ow. Putting shit on the floor. I might as well turn my light on as well. Let's go with medium. Or hard, but...
Good morning, and welcome to the Black Mesa Transit System. This automated train is provided for the comfort and convenience of Black Mesa residents and visitors to the Black Mesa Research Facility. The time is 8:42 a.m. Current topside temperature is 91 degrees, with an estimated high today of 105.
We're gonna meet Gordon Freeman in this one.
Is inbound from the Area 8 topside dormitories to the central transit hub in Area 9. Please keep your limbs inside the train at all times. Do not attempt to open the doors until the train has come to a complete halt at the station platform. In the event of an emergency, passengers are to remain seated and await further instruction. If it is necessary to exit the train, disabled passengers should be evacuated first. Please stay away from electrified rails and proceed to an emergency station until assistance arrives. If your intended destination is a high-security area beyond Sector C, you will need to board a high-security train at the Central Transit Hub. If you have not yet submitted your identity to the Retinal Appearance System, you must report to Black Mesa personnel for processing before you will be admitted to the high-security branch of the transit system. If you wish to transfer to the Sector B or C medium security lines, you may do so before you reach the Central Transit Hub at the Area 9 security checkpoint. Access to the medium security branch of the transit system is for employees of the Black Mesa Research Facility and authorized visitors only, and requires that you wear your security badge at all times.
Oh, hey, look who it is. Hey, man.
Hell if I know. A friend like you. Man. Hey, Calhoun. Looks like we're in for a long day today. Have a good one, Calhoun.
This train is now transferring to the Sector C line of the transit system. This is a medium security area of the Black Mesa facility. Be sure to wear your identification badge at all times.
I'm trying to narrate. Security... Okay. Oh, hello. Oh, that would have been so cool if Gordon Freeman was in there. No, that's impossible. So, now that the narrator up there is shut up, I just want to say, are we going to meet Gordon Freeman in this one? Because... that would be amazing, but
now arriving at Area 3 security facilities.
Good view. Oh, wow, okay.
Hold on a minute. The door's not responding to your pass ID. Let me see if I can get it open on this side.
Okay. Okay, just mind my own business. Oh my god, is that... That's pretty cool.
Okay, I think I got it.
That's really cool. I like that.
Sorry about that, Calhoun. We've been having problems all over the facility this morning. System crashes, security malfunctions. It's a wonder this whole place hasn't shut down yet.
Well, maybe if you hadn't fiddled around with those, that sample of yours, none of this would have happened. You know? Then Gordon Freeman, aka Jesus Christ 2.0, will save everything in the day onto him. Hello? You look like you're having a piss.
Calhoun, you know you can't go on duty without your sidearm and uniform.
Well, I can't see myself, so I didn't know that I was without my sidearm and uniform or whatever. Can I,
Hey, catch me later, I'll buy you a beer.
Okay.
I'm a little busy right now, Calhoun.
Okay, fine. We never got to talk to anybody in the, soldier thing, opposing force. Can I get a snack? Okay, fine then. I got a minor headache, but this game can compensate for that. Nope, okay, that's where I came from. Trainings. Okay, excuse me for that interruption there. Training saves lives. Future. Success.
Nice of you to show up this morning, Calhoun.
Yeah,
I know. Problems with the access system. Hope you're ready for a long shift.
Okay. Everything's fine from you? You got anything? Okay, fine then.
I can't access my files. I can't answer my mail. I haven't even been able to get into my office.
I know, sir, I know. We're doing everything we can to get the problem under control. Just give us some time to...
Time? I don't have any more time. If I'm not able to get my report to the administrator in the next hour, then my job will be in serious jeopardy, and I'll make sure that mine is not the only one.
So you knew about the whole sample being a complete catastrophe thing. So this way or this way? Let's head this way, because it says armory and I assume that's where we get our armor from. Actually, you know what, I'm just gonna check over here because I don't want to miss anything. Hey, buddy.
Sorry, Calhoun, I'm on duty.
Okay, am I gonna find my thing here? So I'm Calhoun, right? Quite. Some very unique last names. My locker isn't here, actually. Oh, wait. Here we go. Oh, hooray. The truth about aliens. Government conspiracies. This guy's a conspiracy theorist. Is that me? Is that my mum or is that my wife? I don't know. What's in the package? What's in the box? A cock. That's what it is. We can't seem to close it either. Okay. Good nice patriot American flag. Oh, hello. Out of order, my ass. Well, can we use these properly? Or, can we shut this, please? Nope. Can't even use them. So where are we going? Yeah. It's December? Well, that's sad. No more Christmas for us then. They look amazing.
Uh-oh, now what? Looks like some people are having problems with the main access lift in Sector G. Why don't you go over there and see what you can do?
Oh, can I open here? That's cool. Oh, I thought I was playing for a second. I knew they could be that shoddy. Can I fiddle with the buttons? No, no, that would be too funny. Okay, let's check this book out. Oh, that's just a cool elevator. I wonder why. Armory, view surveillance. Isn't this... what? Once again, I don't know where to go. Authorized personnel only. That looks malicious a bit. So what happened in the 2000s? Did they just get more confident and make even better material? Authorized personnel only.
How's it going? Here you go, Calhoun. I know you're not on the schedule for a couple more days, but if you want to squeeze in a few shots in the range, there's plenty of room.
Okay then. What you looking at? Can I see? Yeah, we probably should do some training. I was gonna say you were a terrible shot, but I mean, I guess to be fair, I did get much considerable ammo here. What are you doing? What's this? No. Okay, I can't do better than all that. I thought I was going to shoot him there. Oh, that was just to get them... That was just to let me get a good look at my shots. I thought it was pussy mode, or whatever, or something. Whoa.
Good morning, Gordon.
Oh, that's so cool. That's super fucking cool, actually. Can I, So I just... Okay. Throw this to the floor. Oh. Yeah, that was a mistake. Can we just have a moment and admire how creepy that corner is by itself? I don't like that. I don't doubt that that's new. So now what? How long has it been that we... Well, that was a quick 34 minutes. I still got a little bit more time to go. So I assume that we're going... I'm confused.
Ridiculous ties.
Oh no. Now what? What the hell am I supposed to do? I'll bring back the weapon here. Tell you what, I'm gonna end it here. I really like this so far, but I've said that with every other game, and there are points where I get incredibly frustrated, so I am prepared for when things get tough. But I will take the training I had seriously. So, yeah. Goodbye, guys.
We can dance if we want to, we can leave your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to, places they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world, leave the real one far behind.